Tom and Viv by Michael Hastings, with Benedict Cumberbatch, Leah Williams, David Haigh and Judy Parfitt.
Oxford, 1915.
Tom? Why aren't you inside, chattering to all the Don's wives?
I don't chatter very well.
Or dancing?
I won't dance. I find it an enormous effort to be trivial.
Oh, dear.
You aren't mad at me.
I was thinking you've possibly reduced your chances of being a social success here at Oxford by a hideous margin. That's all.
I'm sorry. When are we alone?
Cor blimey. Ain't you a bore and no mistake? Cor blimey. All right. We could go up to London. The house is empty, only the staff, and the house is stuffed with cigarettes, so we can be as decadent as we like. The season's coming up. There's Ascot and Goodwood, the Russians at Covent Garden. Daddy never uses the box, so we don't have to spend a bean.
I don't have clothes for all of these things.
Clothes.
I'm deeply touched. I bask in your light, but I can't do all these things. I love you more than life itself. I love you.
Oh, dear.
Excuse me?
You don't have to be so wet about it.
I don't.
I'm not on fire or something.
Oh.
I know all that anyway. Really? Come on. Let's go. It's a polka. Lots of us. Ever so simple and jump all about. Make an absolute arse of yourself. Oh, Tom. Plunge. Just plunge.
We have a manor house on Anglesey, which we keep for the summer. We close up the London home and take all dogs, maids and children. My husband has estates in Dublin. He is also a landscape artist. He finds a lot to paint on Anglesey. Our daughter, Vivienne, is our eldest child. We also have a son, Morris, who is in the army. Vivi is in Oxford. She is not at Oxford, of course. She is staying with friends of ours nearby. She has met an American boy who studies philosophy. I worry about Vivienne. I worry so much when matters get too close. Last year, I even told one boy's parents she is not allowed to marry because she is not marriage material. Shameful, I know.
Viv.
Yes?
Vivienne.
Love. It's all right. They're all away. Tom.
We shouldn't be in your bedroom.
Nonsense.
I don't know what to do. I don't know how to proceed.
Well, we'll start at the beginning.
Hmm?
Tell all our friends. Take out bands. Do all the things expected of us. Just go through the ropes.
And then?
No one can stop us.
You know, I really look up to my sister. I remember my final term at Malvern. Vivi descended on the school. She gushed like hell about London and the Hippodrome and the ballet. She took us out for a tremendous tea in town. And then she comes back and does an actual cartwheel on the lawn right in front of the housemaster's res, undergarment all to show. I just died. Vivi had a standing joke with me after the war. She asks, how on earth did I survive? I always reply, every bullet missed.
Out of the blue came a telegram. Tom and Viv had run off and married in a registry place. Vivi had contrived it to spite me. With her medical history, I would have put a stop to it. And I was especially afraid for young Tom.
Oh, God, Viv! Welcome home and congratulations on the marriage.
Thank you.
God, it's all been so sudden, hasn't it? Families in a state of shock, really.
Mum and Dad?
On the train from Anglesey, got the telegram this morning, bringing with them thunder and wrath, I should think. Let's get plastered before they arrive. What do you think of the uniform?
I suppose it lends you a shred of distinction.
Oh, squelch. That's the old Vivi, all right.
Is it? I'm not staying.
But you've got to. You can't just elope and not come home and tell us about it.
I'm dropping some clothes off. I want washed, that's all.
Then there was going to be a filthy family row when Mum and Dad got in. I was looking forward to that.
You are a worm.
Anyway, it was a fantastic honeymoon, wasn't it? Bags of candlelight.
Bags? I set light to the hotel curtains with them.
And you must have gone out and seen all the sights and stuff.
I lay in bed all day with the blinds closed and I bolted the door.
Oh, rather. Got stuck into the dreaded sex business.
Every night, Tom took a rug and slept in a deck chair under the pier with a bottle of gin.
Ah. I'm dying to meet the Yank. Every family needs a wild, crazed sort of black sheep. Does he go in for polka dot ties and sort of crashing coloured shirts? Who's this? It's your chauffeur with a laundry basket.
How do you do?
Absolutely.
I'm Tom.
You are?
Yes. Well, I was this morning when I woke up.
Of course you are. God, I'm rude. You must excuse me. I'm Morris.
The fratris?
Sir?
Brother-in-law.
Ah, yes, fratris. My Greek's not up to much these days.
Latin.
Ah.
Squelch.
I've just been hearing about your honeymoon. It's been ripping, hasn't it?
Yes. We're enormously happy. I'm a very proud man.
It's all been such massive fun.
Massive.
I gather you're going to be the poet in the family. I'm afraid I'm pretty much a conservative in that area. I wondered if your poems rhyme.
Massively.
Well, of course, all things don't have to
rhyme. I've written a little ballad about old King Balo's vain duck-billed queen. Had a brightly coloured sphincter, she wiped her bum with tangerine and swallowed saffron tincture.
Oh, pretty hot stuff poetry.
Why, thank you, Morris.
I'm rather keen on Robert Service. The Ballad of Blasphemous Bill? Actually, I know that by heart. Shall I give you a rendition?
Goodbye, Morris.
No, wait. I don't mean to be a squelch. Honest.
Tell Mummy I've left the laundry basket.
I'm awfully sorry. Tom, my mind's jammed with useless bits of info, isn't yours? You can't leave like this. What am I going to say to Mum and Dad? A toast. What? To Tom and Viv on their ripping honeymoon.
Mrs. Eliot?
Yes?
Prescription. The anodyne and the bromide.
Thank you.
But, well, this anodyne is 60% spirit of ether. And the bromide is 90% alcohol.
Well, what about it?
I hope you won't think I'm too keen, but when taken together, these compounds have a dangerous effect.
You think my physician, Sir Frederick Treves, who is also the King's personal physician, erred in some way?
Oh, please, no. See, I'm new here. Well, that's why I talk so. Terrified. I want to become night nurse. The senior chemist here says girls ain't reliable enough for such posts. Well, that ain't true, ma'am, is it?
May I go now?
That'll be 1 shilling and 4 pence, ma'am.
The account is in my mother's name. Mrs. Haigh-Wood!
I won't excuse what we've done. I can't apologise for being in love with Vivi. She's married me on nothing. I owe her everything. I am convinced she is the right person. She has made this sacrifice. She is my life. I don't know what else to do.
You could, of course, sit down.
So sorry, Mrs. Haigh-Wood.
And do something sensible with that hat and brolly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.